The journey to Psychonauts 2 was a long one. From its announcement in 2015 to its release in 2021, Double Fine spent a total of 6 years putting together what I consider to be one of the best sequels of all time. But what makes it a good sequel, Roachie? Let's find out. There's an elephant in this room. Instead of picking up where we left off after the first game, Psychonauts 2 takes place after the events of the game that came before Psychonauts 2, Psychonauts and the Rhombus of Ruin. Rhombus of Ruin came out in 2017 for the PlayStation VR and serves as a bridge for the events between 1 and 2. Now, as much as I would love to tell you about the antics the Psychonauts got up to in that release, I don't have a VR headset, so describing events I can't see for myself is a little impossible. Psychonauts 2 provides a recap that hits every major beat from the first game, but provides very little about the VR game that came after, so for the sake of fairness for those who haven't played Rhombus, let's run with the information they provide us in the recap. Following the rescue of Psychonauts Grand Head Truman Zanotto from Dr. Lobato's underwater lair, God, that's a mouthful, Raz is finally able to live out his lifelong psychic dream of becoming a pencil pusher. During a motivational staff meeting, Sasha and Mia announced the winner of a tropical vacation awarded to their newest employee of the year.
Caligosto Lobato!
Caligosto's told all they need from him is a signature from his boss.
The person who hired you.
If it isn't obvious by now, this entire situation is an elaborate ruse set up by the Psychonauts to find out who hired Lobato to kidnap Truman Zanotto. Unfortunately for them, it doesn't take long for Lobato to realize he's been tricked and set some booby traps of his own, complete with their own complimentary puns.
I don't think you understand the gravity of the situation.
They soon discover that whoever hired Lobato has altered his mind to prevent him from snitching, and that his unwillingness to say who hired him doesn't come from a place of malice, but rather self-preservation.
Who are you protecting?
Myself.
After a little more fighting and brain diving, it's revealed to Raz that the mysterious mastermind behind the kidnapping isn't alone. Upon their return to the real world, Raz is given the name of the weird water snake lady he just saw.
Maligula.
A power-hungry psychic Ford Kruller had killed 20 years prior. And to make matters worse, the Psychonauts have also come to another troubling realization.
There's a mole in the Psychonauts.
Upon arrival at Psychonauts HQ, we meet... Sorry. This is Hollis Forsyth. Agent Forsyth lets Agent Raz know he isn't really an agent because Ford Kruller can't commission Psychonauts. But seeing as how the other agents have taken a liking to him, she grants him entry into the intern program. Raz meets the other Psychonaut interns who immediately show their appreciation for him by stealing his clothes. Like other interns, Raz is later assigned a mentor, but he's nowhere to be found until he is, when they find his brainless body in a cardboard box addressed to the head of the Psychonauts. After discovering the brainless man's possession of a casino room key, the agents head off on their quest to uncover his potential link to a missing agent who's been investigating delusionist activity at the same casino, while the interns go to class. I guess the story ends here, guys. Or does it? Honestly, I'd love to recap the whole story for you because it's really good, but I'd rather you see it for yourself. So what makes Psychonauts 2 a good sequel? For starters, it's actually entertaining. Advancements in the world of technology have made everyone and everything in Psychonauts 2 look really good, thanks to Double Fine's decision to develop the game with Unreal Engine 4. Movement feels buttery smooth and responsive, which means I'm actually grabbing collectibles this time, guys. An assortment of new enemies and abilities makes strategizing and combat super important this time around, especially during heavier sequences. As for the story, it was even better than the first. It opened the floodgates and gave the Psychonauts universe the expansion it truly deserved. Characters feel realer and invite so much more curiosity about them that I wish our dialogues could last forever. I'd also like to make a quick shout out to the cook-off level. The way Raz frantically carries around food from one station to another while under the pressure of a 5-minute timer is just full of the exaggerated swagger of a 10-year-old psychic. Something I failed to mention in my video about Psychonauts 1, subscribe by the way, was my undying affection towards the voice acting in these games.
Tell anybody you got it from me and you're dead. Bye!
Something I also failed to do was look up the cast list after playing because, dude, look at this. We got Zim, Gurr, Spider-Man, Other Spider-Man, Sonic, Andrew Ryan, Funhouse Guy, Other Funhouse Guy, rest in peace, Rooster Teeth. Oh, and Jack Black and Elijah Wood. Also, if you have some extra time, Double Fine and Two Player Productions put together this entire documentary series about the development of Psychonauts 2. Also, a cool little piece of trivia, one of the people that helped make that documentary designed the cook-off level. Seriously, it's so cool. Check it out. If there's one thing I wish to ask of this world you and I both live in, it's that sequels like Psychonauts 2 be plentiful, and that the world round may know of its beauty and existence. Also, how do you refund a game on PSN? If you enjoyed today's video, leave a like, and if you want to see more from me, consider subscribing. Also, leave a comment letting me know what other games I should check out, or your thoughts on Psychonauts 2. Or Spider-Man 2. I hated Spider-Man 2. It sucked. Sony, please give me a refund!